The Ministry of Humanitarian Affairs, Disaster Management and Social Development, the minister rather, Sadia Farouk, says the list of all participating vendors in the modified school feeding program will be submitted to the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC. Farouk, who said this at the Presidential Task Force on COVID-19 daily news briefing on Friday in Abuja, noted that it was for the purpose of transparency and accountability. She said the modified school feeding program was being funded by the federal government, implemented by states and facilitated by the ministry. The minister said it was targeted at heads of households, guardians and caregivers of the pupils already benefiting from the National Homegrown School Feeding Program. She noted that the vendors had been on the program since inception and they were not new ones. She added that the ministry had also invited civil society organizations and non-governmental organizations to help with monitoring of events. And joining us to take a look at the continuing controversy of the school feeding program is Babasola Adegbuyi, who is a social commentator as well. Good afternoon, Mr. Adegbuyi.
Good afternoon, Amaka.
Now, what's your general position on the controversy surrounding the home feeding program of the federal government?
I don't want to come in between the APC and PDP. Let's put them aside. Let's concentrate on the general public. Now, personally, I've never been an advocate of the school feeding right from the beginning, because I see it as a misplaced priority. So, but let's not come down to defend the federal government and the president actually read out his address the public the first time during this period of COVID-19. When I saw that particular paragraph, when he said that the school feeding will continue, I asked myself the question. How? Where? To who? You get. Now, a few days down the line, the Minister of Humanitarian came out to announce that they spend about 687 million naira a day. Let's do the analysis. In Nigeria as of today, we have about 65,000 primary schools, public primary school, not secondary school now, public primary school across the nation. Now, in the 65,000 public primary schools, the total number of pupils we have between primary one and primary three is about 25 million. In other words, the federal government is claiming to be spending 27 naira per child per day. So the question is 27 naira be enough per child per day? Are all the 65,000 public primary schools benefiting from this? Are all the children benefiting from this? Now, let's put that aside. The second one we need to look at now is the now that there is a social distancing, people are expected to be home, there is a lockdown. Now, where are they doing the food distribution? That's the first question. The second question, where are the children? Where are they gathering somewhere? In other words, working against the social, the so-called social distancing? Who are those people in charge of the food distribution? Let's be reasonable enough. 687 million per day for how many students? For which group of people? I doubt it if anywhere in Lagos State is actually benefiting from it. If yes, then who are those actually benefiting?
Right, Mr. Adegbuyi. If I may interject to you, with all this controversy around this school feeding program, should the program be rested? What should take its place, even if it's rested?
We are talking of 687 million a day. In a week, we are talking of about, let's say, about 3.5 billion in a week. In a month, let's assume about 13.5 billion in a month. The federal government is claiming to be borrowing to pay salaries to government workers. That is number one. Number two, we are all talking of the health sector now. The health sector in Nigeria is an ISO, which is secretary to the government of the Federation, has already confirmed too. It's an ISO. Why not spend 14 billion in a month on health sector? Let's see how it will take us. Number three, the parents of these so-called children who are at home with them have no money because some of them have been laid off. What are you doing in order to help them, in order to augment the burden on them, in order to lessen things? What are you doing to help the parents? Number four, the education sector is there. What is the government doing in respect of education sector? If 14 billion is being spent on education sector, we will not be talking of going out of Nigeria to other nations to acquire education. So the government has a lot of things to do with 14 billion. If you look at 14 billion times 12 in a year, that is a huge amount of money.
All right, let's talk generally about palliatives now. In your opinion, how would you assess government's efforts at reaching the vulnerable in this very trying time of COVID-19? Do you think the palliatives are getting to those that it should get to, generally speaking?
Well, from what we are seeing on television or what we are reading on newspaper, we will say they get to some people and not all the people. What do I mean? If they get to all the people, I'm very sure people will not be complaining or lamenting. We see talks. Let's look at Lagos State. In Lagos State, there's an estimate of between 22 and 25 million people living in Lagos State. And the vulnerable is more than 50%. Around those, how many people are actually benefited from this? So-called palliative. If there are so many people, I can tell you the protest by some of the people in the last one or two weeks would not have occurred. There's one of the reasons why the federal government relaxing the so-called lockdown. Okay, we don't have the money to spend. Let these people just go out and work. Let there be coffee between 8 p.m. and 6 a.m. So in the area of palliative, the federal government has not done very well because there is no database that the federal government is making use of.
Mr. Adegui,
you cannot.
All right.
Yes?
I want to say thank you very much in the interest of time. Unfortunately, that's all that we can take from you. Thank you for your interventions, and please do stay safe out there.
Thank you very much.